check out these custom made picture discs. I'll tell you how I got them coming up next. Hi, my name is Frank, and it's my pleasure to welcome you back to Sundays on Channel 33 RPM, that channel all about vinyl, gear, and more. I want to thank all you 33ers for the warm welcome back. In last week's video, I never take your support for granted, so it meant a lot to me that so many of you tuned in and welcomed me back. Now, today we're talking about those really cool picture discs I showed you at the top of this video, and they come from a company called VinylArt.co. They reached out to me recently and asked me if I want to try out their products. VinylArt.co makes custom 7-inch picture discs like these examples I'm showing you right now, and they offered to create a couple for me. Of course, I jumped at the opportunity. As many of you know, I play guitar and I played in bands for years, and I've always wanted to hear my music on vinyl. I'm going to take you through the process of what was involved in creating those picture discs, and I'm going to show them to you in detail. Now stick around to the end of this video because I have a special code that you can use to get your own discount. The way VinylArt.co works is pretty simple. To get things started, you simply go to their website where you upload the digital audio file you want to use along with a high quality image. Using these files, a company prints off your image, masters the audio, and cuts the vinyl, the process of which you can see in this video clip that they supplied me. In the end, you get a perfectly playable picture disc. The maximum playing time for a 7-inch picture disc is 5.5 minutes, but Dan over at VinylArt.co is telling me they're experimenting with 10-inch discs as well, and those would have a maximum playing time of up to 10 minutes. Customers can also choose to order a display frame like this to go along with their record. I got the plain sleeve, which is exactly what I wanted. Now, in terms of cost, a custom picture disc and sleeve cost 34 British pounds, while a custom record and frame costs a bit more. That is 59 pounds. Now, as far as the audio and what sort of audio that you can use on your picture disc, the options are fairly flexible, but you do have to be somewhat careful with copyright. If you own the copyrights to the audio, well, then you're pretty much good to go. Audio can include things such as original music or even wedding speeches, graduation speeches, stuff like that. It's important to note you can get copyrighted tracks cut, but you'll have to pay a licensing fee, which VinylArt.co can handle on your behalf. Okay, as I showed you off the top, I got two picture discs made. The first, you will recognize this logo. This is a Channel 33 RPM logo. And on this disc is the theme song to this show, which I wrote and recorded kind of on a lark a couple years ago. That's on here. It's short. It's like 9 or 10 seconds. So it's looped over and over and over again. So there's that one. And on this one, this is Moment of Doubt. Moment of Doubt is my, I call it my fake band. I do a lot of home recording where it's just me, my guitar, and drum loops. And this is one of the songs I recorded on my iMac. It's called Kill That Killer. It's a tongue-in-cheek title for a song. I'll play you bits of both of these right now so you can see exactly what they sound like. So here comes the review part. What did I think of those records? First, the reproduction of the images on both discs was excellent. There is no visible pixelating or blurring, and the colors are accurate. It would have been nice to have a two-sided picture disc with images on both sides, but as you can see here, the image is only on one side. Of course, I don't think this is a big deal as long as you're aware of this fact going in. As far as the audio quality is concerned, these are very good for a picture disc, and that's the caveat. In my view, in my opinion, in my experience, picture discs never sound as good as traditional vinyl. There always seems to be more surface noise, more pops, more crackles, and these ones are no exception. However, they are still very listenable, and you gotta admit, they got the cool factor definitely going for them. My only real point of concern is that initially the spindle hole was a tiny bit too tight and took some effort, a little bit of effort to get the record down on the platter and then to remove it afterwards. However, after a few listens, it loosened up a bit and became less of a problem. All in all, I gotta tell you, I really dig these. I'm not just saying that because they were comped. This is a unique product, it's a unique service, and this is something I'm gonna hang on to for a really, really long time. If you are interested, check them out at vinylart.co. And when you're ordering on checkout, enter code channel33RPM. That's all one word, no spaces, channel33RPM, and those guys will give you a 10% discount. Let me know what you thought of today's episode in the comments below. Remember, if you enjoyed it, to leave a quick like. If you haven't subscribed yet, click this button and you'll never miss another episode again. I hope you have a fantastic week. Until next time, 33ers, keep on spinning.